Welcome to Drone Maverick. Today we're going to be reviewing the DJI Spark, so let's just get into it.
Right off the bat, your DJI Spark comes with a convenient carrying case, and it has the look and feel of a professional drone, even for its size. Your drone package comes with four foldable wings, which are marked so that you can easily put them onto your drone. Simply match the circle with the circle, and then press down and twist. Your drone comes with three quick-release batteries, which remain secure throughout the entire flight of the drone, and is easy to change out. Press the battery button to see how much power remains. The 12 megapixel camera that comes with this drone is absolutely impressive and takes stunning quality images. Shallow focus allows you to take a picture and then change the depth of field, which means you can take the picture and then select, no, I want this to be in focus, or no, I want that to be in focus. Yes, it's after you take the picture. Amazing. Get creative by using the time shot for those scenes where you never know when something's gonna happen. You can set it to 3 seconds, 30 seconds, to 60 seconds, and you can simply download the images that you want. This is my first interaction with a camera that actually has a gimbal on it. As you fly in high winds, it's incredibly smooth and beautiful. Even when I'm hovering over an object, it still is solid in the air, and it looks like it's just on a tripod, really. As soon as you start to take off and with a twist, then that's when you have to say, okay, that's not gonna work out with the gimbal, but still, for a drone, for its price and its size, it's awesome. Speaking of size, your drone and your smartphone are relatively the same. With the sensors on the front of the drone, it detects an object that's in front of it and comes to a complete stop. Doesn't matter how fast the drone is going, as long as sport mode is off, it will come to a complete stop. The micro SD card is conveniently located on the back of the drone. Simply put it in and press it to lock in place, and you're good to go. The rubber feet on the bottom give the gimbal enough room to move around at startup, and it's also great for landing on hard surfaces.
God, I love everything. I love it when that happens.
Launch the drone from the DJI app right off your phone or right out of the palm of your hand. This is great if you're in like a tall grassy area, or if you just want to see it take off right where you're at. Use the force is a hand gesture which allows you to put your hand in front of the drone, it sees it, and then you can move it around to change the angle of the picture that you're trying to take. Once your fingertips get a hold of this remote, it's gonna feel awesome because it turns the DJI Spark into a race car in the sky. Ascend to the maximum height of your drone and you will hit 400 feet. You can descend and use the gimbal camera for a real dramatic feel. Highlight your subject with your finger and press the green go button. That's how simple and quick these quick shot features are. Cancel anytime by pressing the little X on the left hand corner and the drone will come right back to you. This is great for when you're on the side of a mountain or eating chili in your backyard. Want to learn 5 cool drone tricks with the DJI Spark? Click this link in the upper right hand corner or simply wait till the end of this video to watch that tutorial. Even on the most windiest days, your Spark is still making incredible videos. You'll notice that the gimbal is moving around even as the Spark is moving around, and that's because it's balancing to create this incredibly smooth footage. As you begin to play with the Spark and fly it more often, you'll start to notice that the best footage, the smooth, buttery looking footage, is when the sport mode is in the off position. A fully charged battery will stay in the air for about 13 minutes and 30 seconds, give or take. You want to set the low battery warning to around 30%, because at 20%, the spark will automatically come back to the home position where you started, and then at 10%, it's going to descend and land itself. I keep getting this question asked me all the time, and that's, how far away can you fly the drone and still maintain control? Over a mile is how far I've been able to go, but you need the remote in order to fly that far. The FAA requires that you need 3 statute miles of visibility for obvious reasons. There's bridges, there's electrical structures, there are buildings in between you and the drone. I'm going to leave a link in the upper right-hand corner to watch 13 drone mistakes that new pilots are making all the time, and definitely want to take some time and watch that video. So overall, the DJI Spark is an absolutely awesome drone.
Click on the link in the description below if you want to get it for yourself or you want to get it for someone else. The proceeds when you buy the Spark actually goes to this channel and helps support me so that I can make more content. So if you want to see more drone tricks with the DJI Spark, you go ahead and click right here. If you want to see a video on 13 drone mistakes, you want to go ahead and click right here. And if you want to subscribe, go ahead and click right here. Thank you guys so much for subscribing to Drone Maverick. We're coming close to 200 subscribers already, and the channel is just growing at such a rapid rate. It's really, really cool. So I love you, I appreciate you, and I'll see you on the next one.